lab mates, we have our COVID-19 special edition of the STEM Lab podcast. Most of you have heard of Dr. Kizzmekia Corbett, an American viral immunologist currently involved in first stage clinical trials of COVID-19 vaccine. Dr. Corbett began her research at NIH working on the development of vaccines for severe acute respiratory syndrome, SARS, and Middle East respiratory syndrome, MERS, two types of coronaviruses. Along with her team, Dr. Corbett identified the spike protein in COVID-19 when the virus emerged in December 2019. Because of her work, Dr. Corbett was chosen to lead the team of scientists who partners with the biotechnology company Moderna in development of a promising vaccine that uses genetic code sequences to prompt the body's immune system to react when the spike protein is detected, blocking the infection process. As Dr. Corbett's schedule is extremely busy, she currently is not able to speak with us during our podcast. However, she has been gracious enough to leave sound bites of her explaining the novel coronavirus SARS-CoV-2. Today, we will use those sound bites to modify our interview into what we wish it could be. Dr. Corbett, welcome to the STEM Lab podcast, where we highlight women, especially women of color in STEM. So please, tell us from your perspective, what do we know about the novel coronavirus, SARS-CoV-2, or 2019 and COVID?
What we know is that this virus is in the same family of viruses like SARS. So it is akin and about 80% genetically similar to the SARS virus. We know now, based on some of the transmission data from China, that not only did the virus jump from an animal reservoir into humans, but there is sustained human-to-human transmission, and that's been documented several times over now, including in a hospital setting with healthcare workers. Every day, we're learning more and more and more. Obviously, because this is a novel virus, and even though we've been to this rodeo before with MERS and SARS, there's still so many unknowns.
Dr. Corbett, as you said, there are so many unknowns. So I understand that scientists at the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Disease Vaccine Research Center are studying the coronavirus spike. Can you tell us more about that?
This is the protein that is on the surface of a coronavirus, and it is the protein that the virus uses to attach to the cell and then enter the cell.
Okay, so Dr. Corbett, now that we know how the virus enters the cell, it is my understanding that the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases are using messenger RNA to create a vaccine for the novel coronavirus. Can you explain that a little more to our listeners?
What an mRNA vaccine is we're essentially delivering the genetic material. So we're delivering the messenger RNA that encodes our mutated novel coronavirus spike. The messenger RNA will tell the body to present this spike protein, and the body will respond by creating an immune response. And hypothetically, if all goes well, then that immune response will then be able to see a novel coronavirus before a person gets infected and prevent that infection.
Thank you so much for that explanation, Dr. Corbett. Now, as stated in the intro, the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Disease has partnered with Moderna, which is manufacturing the experimental messenger RNA vaccine. Can you explain that a little bit more to our listeners?
We started this collaboration with Moderna because we wanted to utilize our antigen concept, so our vaccine concept, but deliver it via their platform. So what that means is that we take our sequence from the VRC and we give it to Moderna, and Moderna develops the vaccine.
I know we are in the midst of desperate times for a vaccine, but my question to you is, will scientists still use animal models to assess the vaccine's ability to generate an immune response?
And all of these things are things that we've done vary a lot, actually, with MERS and SARS vaccine concepts, including MERS mRNA. So we know what types of immune responses we're looking for in small animal models. And so we will be testing, evaluating those immune responses, and then we will be establishing a clinical trial.
So Dr. Corbett, I heard you mention clinical trial. I've heard that a phase one clinical trial is planned for this spring. So how long do you think it will be before we have a vaccine in hand?
It would be the upwards of a year before we have data from those types of studies that would support a vaccine that is licensed for general use.
She is such an amazing scientist. Thank you, Dr. Corbett, for giving us some very concrete answers about COVID-19 and how you are working to get a vaccine in place. If you enjoyed this special edition of the STEM Lab podcast with the sound bites of Dr. Kizzmekia Corbett, leave us a comment, click like, and share this podcast episode. If you want to learn more about Dr. Corbett personally, please check out her Black Enterprise podcast interview on YouTube. As always, thank you so much for tuning into the STEM Lab podcast. I'll look forward to chatting with you at the next episode. Bye.